So why does the confusion come? Confusion is a part of any growth. Anytime you move from one framework of working, when you move and learn a new framework of working, there will always be a confusion. If there is no question, how will the answer come, right? So question is very necessary. Question only brings the answer. Answer, if you have answers, then there is no fun in life, right? So let's try to understand and integrate all different approaches, okay? The other day I had a patient whose case history I took. He had come with kidney failure and he was having very few symptoms. I asked him in different ways, and I find he has got some fears. I find he has got one or two dreams. I find that he has got little bit tension here or there. But I do not see anything that I can feel as a major disturbance. Understand what I'm saying? It is there, but I know that this kind of fear can be there in many people. I am jealous, that's okay, everybody is jealous, but am I abnormally jealous, right? I'm afraid that I may not have enough money, but is that enough that it is running my life, it's running the show? So if it is not that intense, I cannot depend on that. Are you there? Ab samjhe main kya bata raha hu? Then I know that this is a situation where I need to find a remedy which fits the local pathology. Or there is a very acute situation. There is not much time for case taking. I want to act immediately on a local symptom. Person is having an heart attack or is in an acute, whatever acute kidney pain or acute, very, don't have much time. At that time, the body throws out whatever symptoms you take and you prescribe. There, the organ remedies, specific remedies get very useful. Sometimes, in incurable cases, some doctors simultaneously give some mother tincture or some organ support remedy along with the main remedy, which is also fine, okay? Leaving apart these extraordinary situations, what is it that is most central to your case taking? What is it about the case taking? What is about the theme or the purpose of your case taking? What are you looking for? Yes, wonderful. So let's make some points so that our confusion becomes little less. It will all come from you only. What she said was beautiful. What we want to see, what is the most bothersome? Bahut acha, wonderful. What's your good name? Anupama, very good. What else you want to see in the case? Perception, okay. What else you want to see? Huh? State, okay. What else? Okay, okay, okay. Way he deals with it, what else? pathology, what else? Arey Baba, you are sitting there on the chair, the patient is in front of you. What are you doing? What do you want to do? Treat him. Good, good. Arey, fundamental apne ko clear karo, everything will be clear. What is individual? Very good. What else?
What is he most sensitive to?
What is he most sensitive to? Okay, what else? Huh? Understand whole. Okay, what else? What else? Socho. What else? Who is that person? Is he a kadka homeopath or a very rich person? What needs to be? What? Tell me what needs to be treated. Man as a whole. What needs to be treated? Man as a whole? How do you treat man as a whole? पूरा का पूरा उसको मिक्सर ग्राइंडर में डालना है. आई एम गिविंग यू अगेन काफी बिफोर मास्टर्स कोर्स ये मास्टरी जरूर करना. अभी सी यू कैन सी द क्लैरिटी इज नॉट देयर. सो थिंक अगेन. वंस दिस क्लैरिटी कम्स एवरीथिंग विल बी मोर क्लियर. वो सेंसेशन की मगजमारी क्यों करते हैं आप लोग इतना बैठ के? टू आवर यू आर सिटिंग. आई एम सिटिंग फॉर 3 hours ऑल्सो समटाइम्स. वाई आर यू आस्किंग ऑल दिस सेंसेशन? वाई आर यू आस्किंग ऑल दिस सिम्टम्स? लाइक डॉक्टर गौरांग मे डू अ वेरी आर्टिस्टिक केस टेकिंग, टेक आउट वेरी पिक्यूलियर सिम्टम्स, राइट? Dr. Shankaran will take out exact rubrics, right? Dr. Gandhi will pick up exact evolutionary aspects of the case, right? Dr. Dinesh will find a perfect sensation. What is this? Why do you want to do all this? What are you looking for?
PQRS.
Why do you want peculiarity? So that you can find a match with the remedy. So what are you trying to match? What in the individual? Yeah, say if I came with a scarf like Devanand. Okay. Now, no other teacher comes like a scarf with Devanand there. What will you give him? Devanand 200? Yes. What is it? Use the mic, no? Thoda achha hoga ye. Discussion is very good, no? So this will be like, give her the mic. Everybody should use the mic, yes?
So like, if we say something or use that word, so the very next word or name that comes in our mind, that is the individuality of that person which makes him like different from the others, and that we want to know.
Okay.
What is
very
that?
Good, very good. What else? Yes? Disturbed vital force. Oh my God.
I think that when you were saying about each doctor, it's that they know what they're looking for.
What are they looking for, I'm asking you?
So, like, as you said, like, Dr. Sankaran can match the exact rubrics. Dr. Dinesh can get the perfect sensation. So Dr. Dinesh is going more for that sensation, for the patient to talk about it, not so much as...
I understand all this, but I'm asking you, what are all of them looking for?
For the source language, for what's the remedy?
Exactness. Give the mic. So, see, that is why there is confusion, because you don't know what they are looking for, and you are saying I'm confused. What are they looking for? What are you looking? What are they looking for?
Whole is exact.
आवाज में दम नहीं है, बाजू में पावरलेस है ना, ऐसा हेल्पलेस पावरलेस कुछ ऐसा ही. ओके, या
सॉरी. आफ्टर ईच एंड एवरी सेशन ऑफ केस टेकिंग मे बी वी हेल्प द पेशेंट टू अंडरस्टैंड हिमसेल्फ और हरसेल्फ इन अ बेटर वे, एंड सो डू वी डू दैट. लाइक
व्हाट डू वी अंडरस्टैंड, दैट्स व्हाट आई एम आस्किंग यू.
इट हेल्प्स अस आल्सो टू नो
व्हाट अंडरस्टैंड, नो व्हाट.
So, can I? That one experience which that person, whatever the word it is, like...
Which word?
Which he feels in everywhere in his life, whatever the situation...
What is that that he feels everywhere?
Core of the patient.
Core of the patient. Non-human.
Exact, complete.
Okay. Socho, you are all right in some ways, but you are missing something fundamental. Okay. Now I'll make it little more simple. Okay. Say I have a patient who has got gas in the abdomen. Okay. He has got distension of the abdomen. Okay? And this distension of abdomen is worse at 4 p.m. And this particular man has history of right-sided renal stones. Okay? And he has craving for sweets. And he has flapping of LNSI. And he is having fear of being alone. And he wants someone in the next room. Okay? By chance, he happens to be dictatorial. And he also happens to be cowardice.
Oh, shit.
Okay. Now, this is lycopodium, right? Why is it lycopodium? Why is it lycopodium? Portrait, what is this? What is this? What is this?
Different symptoms when come together.
Very good. Very good. You're coming closer now. Okay. So.
Sir, pattern.
Yes. This is a pattern. You understand what is this word? What makes individuality? What gives the individuality? Is how each one is patterned. Recognize that all of us are in some ways patterned. Clear hai? All of us are in some ways programmed. Clear hai? Do you get this clearly? Get this in your mind very clearly. Aji abhi, she is programmed and patterned to feel that she is not able to go one step further and she is helpless, powerless, aage kuch nahi kar paati ho, like I have been tied. What is this? This is a pattern. Right? That I become blank. Now she has influenced this field of this pattern is an energy field. Are you understanding one thing? The pattern is an information field. Yes or no? Is a disturbance of the life force. And she could put the color yellow in it and that healed her to some extent. It can be to a large extent. Also, time will tell. But what happened? The pattern changed. What entered into the pattern? Yellow. So now no longer it is that pattern. You get my point? So when something in the pattern moves, then some sort of a healing should occur. Maybe big, small, whatever, you know, I'm not talking about. But most important aspect here is that each of these wonderful masters you saw in this room over the past 6 months understood and recognized a pattern. So one thing that you need to be very clear in your head, very clear, abhi aaj hi clear karna hai isko. You are not going to walk with this confusion tomorrow. The conclusion is that if you understand a pattern, you create a possibility for a remedy. Get this inside. Each of the master was understanding and carving out a pattern, right? Whether on the basis of boxes of repertorial rubrics, where you see the same pattern run through in all the boxes, yes or no? Or there is a sensation, and that sensation allows to understand the whole pattern. Or there are three keynotes that allow you to understand the pattern. As soon as you recognize a pattern, you are ready, you are likely to be ready with one remedy. Because in this gas distension at 4 o'clock, right kidney stone, craving for sweet, flapping LNSI, fear of alone, wanting someone in the next room, dictatorial, cowardice, this is a pattern. Supposing in this pattern, I add kill desire too. Will you still give lycopodium? Will you not rethink? Why? Why will you rethink? Whatever, when you look at all these things together, will you say, this is not an important symptom. We should not consider this. All these symptoms are important. If it's a prominent thing, then we can, right? Then what has happened now? the pattern has changed. Iske andar, if I put jealousy, 5 marks, and if I put dreams of snakes, plus, 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 okay. What will this become? Lack is this. Hai ki nahi hai? What changed? The pattern changed. You understand? So, the fundamental is that each of the master is expert at eliciting a pattern. And then recognizing through whatever means, either through case-taking tools in the sensation approach, or through repertorial tools, or through keynote tools, or through intuitive tools, or through specifics, or through hot chili, like what Dr. Vijaykar uses, certain patterns. You get what I'm saying? Or how Jeremy Scher would use the patterns, or how Jan Scholten would use the patterns, or how Mahesh Gandhi would use these patterns. So what happens is, the next step that you need to be very clear. What is the next step now? The next step is, what is the framework in which you are understanding this pattern? Okay? There is a framework, like the allopathic doctor has. The modern medicine doctor will have a framework under which he understands the symptom and puts a label of diagnosis. He works with that framework. You get what I'm saying? So, next step is to understand what framework each master used in recognizing the pattern. Is there any confusion now? Tell me. Is there some clarity or not some clarity? Okay. Now let us go to the next step. What you people have learnt in last 6 months is a wonderful exposure to multiple frameworks of understanding a pattern. Okay? If the case is clearly expressing at a sensation level and it is giving you, say for example, an animal remedy, clearly, will you take the framework of miasm and try to see if it hota hai ki nahi hota hai? You understand what I'm saying? Does every framework need to fit in every case? You get what I'm saying? A framework that is most suitable for the information that you have been able to elicit will work. Underline this, write this very clearly. After you have elicited the information, I could understand from the very first sharing that you did was, I'm thinking a lot and I'm trying to go deeper and I want more details and I feel as if my case is not complete. That's what you were trying to tell me, right? It was like dil mange more. It's not coming together. Always there will be feeling, have I done enough? I have not found enough. Okay? The only way to overcome this is to take a break after 1 hour of case taking. Tell the patient, I need a cup of tea, give me 5 minutes, I have some emergency patient, another, I am to talk to him. They say whatever you want, say I want a 5 minute break, please wait, and then take the patient again. In that 5 minutes, restructure yourself. What is the pattern that is showing up? How can I complete this pattern? How do I understand this pattern? Write down the 5 most characteristics that have been very clearly elicited so far. Okay? So now you know that these 5 characteristics are very clear. Now let me see where I go. I did this very often. Even today I do this often. When everything gets too clogged up, then say, okay, just a moment. Sit out for 5-10 minutes, I take you in again. Give yourself time. When you see doctors here, they are masters. They work for years. It's in their things like this, you know, how I can elicit like this. And in 15 minutes, in 1 hour, I can elicit everybody's sensation. 5 minutes it will take me. Just go around and everybody's sensation will be out. That is because we have practiced it again and again and again. When I was, for first 10, 12, 15 years of my practice, I used to make a break. I used to write down, okay, what are the main things that have come up so far? How do I go further? You create a strategy. You are more clear. You are more calmer. Initial days in your new cases, give little more time. 2. One thing you must understand, that treat a person only who has chosen to come to you. Like Darshan was saying, you get your relatives and they will say ki ye khapa raha hai. When the patient you are treating for free, he doesn't value your being, are you there? When the person agrees to pay you 1,000 and sits on the chair, it is a different ball game. Because that person trusts that you are the one who will help him. And you need to create your own personality. You need to create your own inner strength, your own inner being that people trust coming to you. You need to learn that nobody is perfect. No homeopath, no Rajan Shankaran, no Jayesh Shah, no Mahesh Gandhi finds right remedy in all cases. I give you in writing. I am saying it on record here. But we have an approach, we have a process that the patient is plugged into and I am plugged into. So I will keep the patient and myself engaged in the process. And the process for a homeopath is to recognize, revise, revive, reframe, understand deeper the pattern. When in the next session you get lot of jealousy and you get dreams of cobras, then you will think, no, ki ye lycopodium tha, lekin abhi I have to revise my perception. Why? Because you are plugged in. Because you know all the symptoms that you have elicited before very carefully. You have written them down also. In the end you have made a totality. And then you will recognize what was not in the totality or what needs to be added, what needs to be go in to understand the whole. And this whole can keep growing. There is nothing which is complete and over. Nothing that is finality here. It is a process. I have so many clients over 35 years, they have been still coming to me. I know I cured him with pulsatilla before 35 years, but today that's not helping him. Today I am giving him falcon, for example. Because I have grown, are you there? And homeopathy will give you results, I am telling you, if you recognize a pattern which is deep enough, which is peculiar enough, which is individual enough, it will help. Even if it is 4 peculiar symptoms, it will help. And the growth has to occur step by step. All of a sudden, you cannot straight away start painting beautiful pictures. Are you there or not? It takes little bit of time, but you start with a smaller picture, then it grows, 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 but you got the tools how to grow. You've been exposed to all methodologies here. So, for example, in a case which expresses very deeply at a sensation level, and the person says, I've got severe bronchial asthma, doctor, I feel all my, this chest is like this, it is just, I am feeling this like this, everything is going like this, I can't breathe, I feel it's like this. Are you there? So, when the case is expressing so much at the sensation level, at the hand gestures level, right away, I will not be interested in this moment to ask when is it more. कॉमन सेंस है कि नहीं है? What shows up spontaneously? 3-4 words are important. Write down this. What shows spontaneous? What shows clear? What shows with intensity? And what expresses as peculiarity? Spontaneity, clarity, intensity, peculiarity. That is where our focus should go. Once this is very clear in your mind, there will be no confusion. You will learn how to remove less important things of the case. Because she said, probe what is most bothersome. Why is it important to look at most bothersome? Because in the most bothersome, you will discover the pattern easily. Sometimes a relationship problem with the husband or mother-in-law can express much more deeper and clearly the pattern than a physical disease. Sometimes an asthma can clearly express a pattern than anywhere else in the body or the mind. Like this person said that my chest is cramping, all my arteries are going like this. So all I did was just tell little more about this. How does this feeling? Now if the person is not experiencing this and Darshan will ask, ki, no, tell me how the lungs are going like this, he will laugh, no? He will say, kya mere saath kya lagaya hai? So when to ask what question? And to whom ask is very, very common sense. It is not homeopathy sense, it's common sense. Use your common sense. This person, is he expressing his disease at that level? Two, is he sincere enough that he is sitting in front of you? Ki jabardasti se aake baitha. Initially, it happens. Many clients come to you, forced by somebody or by chance they sit in front of you, and it can be a very difficult experience. But it can also be a challenging experience. My second case of my life was when I was in the clinic and I was cleaning the table. And a patient comes and asks, "Where is Dr. Jayesh Shah?" That time my weight was 45 kilos. And the patient asked, I said, "Yes, I am Dr. Jayesh Shah." He looked upar se niche tak. Kahi galat jagah mein aa gaya hun. He wanted to go away. But somehow, aa to gaya abhi nahi ja saka. Somehow. And he sat there. Now it is question up to me, right? All I did in my mind was said, by the end of this consultation, this person should take appointment for 3 of his family members. And I started taking the case. As soon as the case over, she said, "When can I get my wife?" This is what you need to learn from all these doctors who are teaching you here. When you are sitting and you get confused, now take one deep breath and just assume that Dr. Shankaran has come to help you. And what will he do if he is stuck in this situation? And see what happens to you. ये deeper नहीं जा रहा है, आँख बंद किया है लेकिन अंदर नहीं जा रहा है, तो जयेश शाह को याद करो, दिनेश सर को याद करो. See how your teachers did it. Master's course is meant so that you see all the teachers again and again, one after the other, do it every day. Everything is there inside of you. Your intention is clear to help the person to understand the case to the best that you can. Once the information starts coming, then it is a free flow. Then it is common sense to see which direction this is coming. Is it heavily manifesting on the physical organs? Then you say, okay, I'm going to ask about the physical organs. In that, is it the sensation which is more intensely experiencing, or is it the facts or the modalities that are showing up prominently? Where is the peculiarity, intensity, clarity? All this you ask, what has come very spontaneously? So when this moment says spontaneously that I am feeling this, I am not going to give her a list of modalities, tick mark here when it is worse. I am going to ask her, describe this, because that's the level at which she is expressing. Then she said, this feels like my freedom is lost. So what has happened now? What has happened? What has happened? Think again. It's actually a case. I'm talking actually about a case. It has gone from local to general. Now this is very interesting. So it's all about this and free. What is this and free? What is this and free? What is this and free? It is a pattern. Samajh mein aaya? Are you getting it? This is the pattern. Now you investigate this pattern. Ye kya hai? What is this? Give this all your attention. That's how I use. Or you can ask, tell more about this and this. Or I will say, close your eyes, experience this, experience this. or the person says that I am getting a lot of cough. We had today a case. She was coughing and coughing and coughing like an insane. She is not giving many modalities, not giving any peculiarities. We are not able to understand her case, and yet she is coughing, and she has taken all allopathy possible. She has taken all homeopathy possible. I saw her today in the morning. She was waiting for me to come back from wherever I was, and she was coughing and coughing. I am not finding anything in her case. I ask her about her mind symptoms. She says nothing. I ask about modality. She says nothing. She is only coughing, coughing, coughing. Some symptom like eyes watering. Nothing coming up. After 15-20 minutes, I feel, now what do I do? But she is in a lot of cough distress. So I ask her, tell me, where do you feel the cough? Then she said, I feel it here. So I said, let your finger remain there. What are you feeling here? She said, I feel either pricking or tickling. Then I got one symptom. Cough from tickling in the throat pit. This is the throat pit. Okay. Then you need to know your repertory well. Everything comes. Now here I am not going to use my close your eyes approach. Are you there? Hey, nahi wo aankh band kare kidhar nahi jayegi wo. I know. I have done it before with her. So I want to find a remedy which has this intensity of cough with tickling in the throat pit. And then I gave her the remedy Rumax. Rumax is a very important remedy for tickling in the throat pit with all severe kind of cough. Now in this case I am 100% sure that there is no way she doesn't want to talk about her mind, she doesn't want to talk about anything. What is happening most intensely is where the manifestation or the clue to the remedy is. If I ask her to close her eyes and feel that tickling, 99%, as I know this person, she will go into nowhere. She will tell me, doctor, you are the stupidest person on this earth. They will laugh at how Darshan was saying, right? Because you are not at the wavelength of the person. Sometimes at the level at which I am able to bring the person to my wavelength. But then also I know ki this person and this situation is not for that kind of a work. So what is very necessary to be sensitive to is to understand how the case is coming to you. So my suggestion would be that go into the sensation approach when the sensation is manifesting with in the body, in the mind, in the dream, or in the hand gestures, intensely, clearly, spontaneously, peculiarly. Then sensation approach seems to be the right approach for this case. If you try to drag the person into that approach, you will be in some difficulty. Somebody who is very experienced at sensation approach can take a person to that sensation level just because he has reached that level. Are you there? For you, I would say you have to begin with steps. Take the sensation approach in cases where the sensation is very clearly manifesting. Also, I would say take the sensation approach in bits and pieces. For example, there is a sensation showing up in the dream or the sensation showing up in a fear. Then you can pick that up. And then you will see the person will go deeper. So here I will go to the next step. when the case is not flowing, right? This was, some of you had this difficulty. The case is not flowing. So what needs to be understood is that any case can be, or any phenomena, case is a phenomena, a pattern, a program, you can perceive it from multiple windows. You cannot understand a pattern from one window. So, if I had to understand the pattern of this room, that this pattern has a projector, and this pattern has a screen, and this pattern has chairs and tables, and this pattern has these computers, whatever. So, if I look from that window, what will I see? You will see that, okay, you will see a few chairs on the end, you will see one camera there. Will you say this is a classroom? Are you there? But what you are seeing from there is important or not important? It's a part of that. Then I put you above the camera, there is a window from there. What will you see? You will see four more benches and this. Still, is it complete? Then you will see from here, this window. What will you see? This strip, okay? Then you put these three together, then some little more information will come. Then you will look through the middle window. Then you will enter inside in the center and look at everything. I've reached the core. Now I am able to see Jayesh Shah and all the students. Then everything comes together, no? Okay, this is a lecture by Jayesh Shah. This is TOS. This is, he's talking on homeopathy. Abhi sab samajh mein aa gaya. Everything has come together. Are you there? Like this, in a case, you look at the case from multiple windows. You look from dreams, from fears, interest, hobbies. You look from painful occurrences in the life. You look from past history when the patient was very disappointed. You look from childhood history. You look from childhood fears. You look from mother's nature, father's nature. You look from what other people have to say about this patient, right? You look from the physical symptoms. You look from the general symptoms. So all these are different windows. And what are you trying to do looking through these windows? You are trying to make, understand the pattern. And how do you construct a pattern? By making a totality of what is spontaneous, intense, clear, peculiar. Even when I do meditation sessions, these are the things I am looking for as a homeopath. What is strange, rare, peculiar, intense, spontaneous, clear, bas. Once you get hang of that, aapko case ka core, you caught the core of the case. You may not have got the detail, you did not get the remedy at all, doesn't matter. Be brave not to find the remedy. Have the courage not to find the remedy, but have the patience to find this pattern. Sometimes this pattern can be rubrics. Sometimes the pattern gets illuminated by a dream. Sometimes by a physical sensation. Sometimes by the pathology. So every teacher you meet, you want to learn how he recognizes the pattern. Slowly and gradually, you will be able to learn how to construct a pattern on your own, right? And then that teacher is able to do it in only one way. But I am able to do it in all the teachers' ways. believe me, I use all methodologies, from specifics to intuitive prescribing, to sensation approach, to box approach, to repertorial approach, to reference works approach, to meditation approach, through healing approach, and through multiple healing approaches. Only skill is how you negotiate through the case. That is what is causing you the confusion. And don't ever believe that what you need to prescribe is not there here. We have to trust what shows up. लिख लो आप कैपिटल बोल्ड में चाहे जो टीचर को जो बोलना है वो. I am telling you this. Trust what shows up. In your presence, with your capability, with your abilities, with your confidence, with your growth level in this moment, whatever shows up is for you to work with. Because you cannot work with what is not showed up, right? The art and the fun is to work with whatever that shows up in your presence. And you will have to trust that whatever is showing up is enough to find the right remedy. मुझे इतने में से अभी दवा ढूंढना ही है. Then you write down the symptoms of the pattern. And you will know immediately in 5 minutes what more questions you have to ask. Are you willing to give that 5 minute break? Are you willing to take that 20 minutes more for the patient? Is the patient willing to sit with you that 20 minutes more? Will depend on what? Will depend on how clear you are in this moment about what you are expecting from him or her. If you show confusion on your face, what will happen? Whenever you are confused, remember me and say, this is very interesting. When I don't understand something, I tell myself, this is very interesting. Even today I say, this is very interesting. What does that mean? The moment I tell myself, this is very interesting, there is a smile on my face compared to all the wrinkles on my face. And the moment I realize that I don't recognize this, I don't understand this, this is very interesting, the game becomes different. What works for me, again, underline, capital, bold, is to be playful. Don't be very hard on yourself. One thing is very clear here in this class, that everybody has expanded. I can see very clearly, everybody has expanded. Now, it is to take this expansion, make this expansion interesting. To say that this expansion is interesting and to say that this expansion is confusing will change your ball game. Yes or no? And don't postpone success. Don't postpone that I still have to learn this much, after that I will get success. Throw that out of the window from here today only. I got success on the very first day I started practicing when I knew very little. My very first patient got better. because I gave him medicine because he was aggravation of headache from sun and he was worse from consolation, I had given him Netramur. And till today he gives me blessings. Okay, I was your first happy patient. I didn't need to ask him sensation. Today when I think, I feel Netramur was a wrong remedy. Which is the right remedy? Which is the right remedy? The right remedy is one that works. It's not one that my fantastic mind can analyze. Homeopathy gives results at every step. Every step becomes an encouragement to go to the next step. So when do you know that you have reached the sensation? I'm going by the questions that you have asked. When you find that you are in the center of the room and that one thing coming in the case helps you to understand many aspects of the case. Okay? Like the person said that I am tied, I cannot move, somebody is controlling me, I feel I have been trapped, I feel as if I am in the cage. And then he says that I'm not feeling free, and then you ask him how does free feel, and then he says free feels like I've just got out of the cage, and it feels that I'm high up on the sky, and it feels like lightning, it feels like speed, it feels like power. Then you can understand, no? Something has come up which helps you to understand many things that you could not understand. That is the level. When you reach in a sensation case, it comes through fears, dreams, interest, hobbies, passions. It feels like the galloping horse going with the power. It feels like my body has dissolved and I'm like merged into the sky. Are you getting what I'm saying? So, when some information reveals, which helps you to explain, understand many aspects of the case, then you will go to the next level and ask the dreams, and ask the fears, ask the interest, hobbies. Then all those little gaps from different windows, when you see it, it will get complete. So, if you are stuck in one window, go to another window. And have multiple windows. Write down all these windows are there. Dreams, fears, interest, hobbies, childhood, most stressful time in your life, most difficult relationship of your life, most bothersome thing in your life. Nature of your parents, your relationship with your parents, main things in your physical symptoms. What is it that you are not able to bear in a movie, in a cinema, in a drama? What is it that you can't read in a newspaper? What is it that when you see you get very fascinated? What makes you very relaxed? What makes you very joyous? Keep all these windows. Keep all the chitka ke rakho udhar, so that you know I have many things which I can ask. If not one, go quickly through the windows and see which window is hot. Which window is charged? You'll be surprised that the window of interest hobbies is very charged, or window of the mother-in-law is very charged, or the window of my art and drawing is very charged. Another important tool is storytelling. I asked her, tell me the story of a person who is not able to go one step further, and she could make a story, right? Art and drawing you can use. Draw this. Draw something that will show this distress. So have many tools. All teachers have given you so many tools. Make a summary of all the tools and have it on your desktop. So you are always ready when you are stuck, where to go next, and move fast. Once you have made a linear investigation, it comes to a point where you can't go further. Are you there? Then what you do? You need to go lateral. Then in the lateral you will see which window is hot and again go vertical on that. Is it making sense? So if there is a weird remedy coming which convinces you, have the daring to be weird. Give it. Give it with all your courage. I am giving you the license. Say, Jayesh Shah gave me the license. If you are convinced everything is coming together for you in the moment, give it. Give it with a big smile on your face and a pat on your back. If something weird is showing up in your presence, understand you are a good homeopath. If only patthar chhap information is coming in your presence, come again for the master's course. Can we mislead the patient? No patient is going to say anything that doesn't belong to him. Actually, the patient leads you. You have to just go through and encourage him to walk that path. It is like delivering a baby. You don't pull it out, right? You just create situation that the baby is normally born. Sometimes you need to use a forceps or pull it out or do a caesarean. But your aim is to how gently you get it out. What is important in the case? I've explained you. Get these four words clearly. Okay? How to take person to the next level? So what is the next level? It's only one very simple technique, is trust and persistence. Trust, persistence and playfulness. Lot of time you have to give. Don't be in a hurry. It is going to come. Just tap a little more. You can take him to next level by going to another window which has more energy. Like the window of this physical disease is not very, very intense. I need to go to the window of the mother-in-law. I need to go to the window of the fears. Or whatever, wherever there is more disturbance. That is the area where you will be able to go more deeper. Why? Normally, wherever there is a lot of emotions, that is the area where the person is likely to go deeper. Because if he says, I feel very closed, and she starts weeping, then you know there is energy there. Are you there? It's alive. It's living. Whatever that thing is alive, it's living. It has got charge. Then you go to a deeper level. So when you are not moving to the deeper level, means this window is not having enough charge to go deeper. So go as far as you can go and then move laterally to another window, to another window, to another window, till you find the next window which has a charge, which has a disturbance which you can probe. Then connect the two. All information ultimately is pooled. Fears, dreams, interest, hobbies, delusion, sensation, all is one. Then you can interchange rubrics. You can use delusion rubric for dream and dream rubric for delusion and delirium rubric for dream. Everything becomes the same. Delirium business is same as delusion business, is same as talks of business, is same as dreams of business. Understand what I'm saying? Then it becomes creative use of the repertory, materia medica. Delusion cockroach is same as fear cockroach, dreams cockroach. They are all different aspects of the cockroach insects. Another aspect is to understand what is the sponsoring feeling. Say, I've got fear in the dark, but what is sponsoring that fear in the dark? Oh, there will be something unexpected. Somebody can come from behind and stab me. So what is now important? Is the fear of dark important or the somebody will come from the back and stab me? What is more important? Correct? So that is the sponsoring feeling. So that is more important. Yes?